स्टैंडर्ड 7th इंग्लिश मीडियम मैथ्स। यस्टरडे वी स्टार्टेड एक्सरसाइज 2.5 एंड क्वेश्चन 1 वाज फिनिश्ड, ओनली 1 वाज लेफ्ट दैट आई लेफ्ट फॉर योर होमवर्क। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2। इट सेड दैट एक्सप्रेस एज रुपीस यूजिंग डेसिमल्स। नाउ वी नो दैट रुपीस एंड पैसे, we know that the 1 rupee is 100 paise. It means that when you want to convert paise into rupees, we have to divide that number by 100. So now we will start at first one is 7 paise. 7 paise means rupees how much? 7 upon 100. Now, if you want to convert it into decimal form, what we have to do? Check how many zeros are there with one in denominator. And that much decimal places must be in the numerator. Here there are two zeros. It means that rupees, here 7 is there. We need two decimal places, but here is only one. So one, you can put another zero and then 0.07. So 7 paise is equal to rupees 0.07. Second is rupees 7 rupees 7 paise. 7 rupees 7 paise. Now 7 rupees is already there, so we will keep as it is. Plus 7 paise we will do like that same, plus rupees 7 upon 100. It means rupees 7 plus, we already did here, it is 0.0 so plus rupees 0.07. Now you have to add them, rupees 7.00 because there is nothing here, plus 0.07. So here 7, 0 and 7. So our answer is rupees 7.07. This is only to show you that how to add. If you can add directly, you don't need to do that, or you can do it on the rough page also. But for your knowledge, I just do that one here. Take the third one. Third one is 77 rupees 77 paise. 77 rupees 77 paise. So we will keep rupees as it is. Plus 77 paise means rupees 77 upon 100. As I told you, that we have to divide it by 100. Now two decimal means 0.77. So rupees 77 plus rupees 0.77, because there is two digit and we need two decimals, right? So you put point here and that zero. So rupees 77 plus rupees 0.77. So you can write down rupees 77.77, because if you add that, you will get that answer. So rupees 77.77. Next, fourth one. Fourth one is like that, only 50 paise. 50 paise means rupees 50 upon 100. So here, two decimal is equal to rupees 0.50. Here 0 is necessary. If you don't write down, then it also, but when we know that paise will be in the two digits sometimes, so mostly we have to write down 0 at the end. Doesn't matter, you can cancel here, but whenever we're talking about the rupees and paise, we keep two digit after the decimal, so we don't have to cancel that 0 and write down as rupees 0.50. Similarly, the last one, fifth one, is showing that there are 235 paise. Here also we do the same thing, 235 upon 100 rupees. So now 2 decimal means we will put the point here, so is equal to rupees 2.35, because we need 2 decimal places, so 3, 5 and 3 after that, so answer is rupees 2.35. Now question 3. Question 3 says that express 5 centimeter in that number 1. Express 5 centimeter in meter and kilometer. In meter and kilometer. So 5 centimeter. Now we must know the relation between meter and centimeter. 1 meter is how many centimeter? 100 centimeter. So same like rupees and paise, we convert, we divide by 100. So here also we have to do the same, is equal to 5 upon 100 meter is equal to 0.05 meter. Now again we have to convert it into kilometer also. To convert it kilometer, you know that 1 kilometer is equal to how many meters? 100 or 1000? 1 kilometer is 1000 meter. So we have to divide again by 1000. So that is the first answer. And then again we have to divide with the 1000. So we can use that one also. 5 upon 100 multiply by again 1000. That is the kilometer. Because we convert kilometer. So again we have to divide by the 1000. So there is how many places now? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 decimal places. But we have only 1. So 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. And then that 0. That is the kilometer. So first answer was in meter. For that we divide 100. And then again, meter to kilometer, we have to divide by 1000. So we use that one and we divide by 1000. So there is 5 zeros here. So we have to count from the right side, 1, then 4 zeros, and then we put the point. Then the second is also there. Express 35 millimeter in centimeter and meter and kilometer. Meter and kilometers. So from millimeter to centimeter also, into meter also, and into kilometer also. So 35 millimeter. We know that 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter. So we have to divide only by 10. Is equal to 35 upon 10 centimeter is equal to 0, no, not 0, because there is only 1 0 here. So we will need only 1 decimal place. So answer is 3.5 centimeter. Now centimeter to meter again. That is your first answer. So now again we have to divide by 100, because 1 meter is 100 centimeter, so is equal to 35 upon 10 into 100 meter, means 1, 2 and 3, so 35 means 1 and 2, so we need another, and then 0.035 meter. Now again in kilometer, means again divide by 1000, so is equal to 35 upon 10 and 100 is there. And another we have to put 1000. So how many zeros are that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 zeros. 6 zeros means we write down 35 here. Then 1, 2, how many zeros? Missing 4. And then that much with the kilometer. So we express the 35 millimeter in centimeter, then in meter, and then in kilometer. Number 4, it says that express in kilogram. So first one is 200 gram. Now we know that 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 gram, and therefore we have to divide by 1000. So it is equal to 200 upon 1000 kilogram. Now here also, as I told you, in the rupees and paise, because it is 1000, means the gram will be in 3 digits, and therefore we don't have to cancel any zeros, and we have to write down 1, 2, 3 are there. There was 0.200 kilogram. If you write down 0.2 kilogram, it is also not wrong, but generally we will keep it. So you can write down that also, not a problem. It is also the right answer. So if you write down this answer or this answer, it will be accepted. Second one is 3470 gram. So is equal to, as I told you, we have to divide by 1000. 3470 upon 1000. And as I told you, don't cancel. So 1, 2, 3 means 3470. 1, 2, 3. So 3.470 kilogram. If you want to separate it, 3 kilogram and 470 gram. But you don't want to separate it. Then the third one. What does the third one say? 4 kilogram and 8 gram. 4 kilogram, 8 gram. Here, be careful. Here, you have to be very careful. 4 kilogram we will write down as it is. Plus 8 gram means 8 upon 1000 kilogram. It means that it is 4 kilogram plus, now 1, 2, 3 digits. So 1, 2 and 3. That much kilogram. So now when we add, it will be 4.008 kilogram. Here there is a chance of making mistake. Sometimes people don't do that. If it is in the, like in the MCQ, you can have 4 kilogram, it means 4.8 kilogram. It is wrong. Why? Because gram to kilogram, when we convert, we have to divide by 1000. So not directly you can put 0.8. Because 8 gram means 0.008. Therefore, be careful when it is in the MCQ. If it is direct, then you will be able to, because 8 upon 1000 you have to put. But in a hurry, don't do that mistakes. Now, question number 5. In that, we have to write down the numbers in expanded form. Write the following decimal numbers, decimal numbers in the expanded form. In the expanded form, the first number is 20.03. So we start with 2. 2 is in which place? We know that from the point left side is the unit's place or 1's place, and second is 10's place. So 10's place means we have to multiply it by 10. So 2 multiply by 10 plus 0 multiply by 1, because in unit place it is 0. Or if you don't write down, then it is also, but better that we can write down. Plus here also 0 into 1 upon 10, because yesterday also we learned about it in the that decimal place value chart, that after that point, right side first is the 1 upon 10, means tenths place. So we have to multiply by 1 upon 10. And the next last one is 3 multiplied by 1 upon 100 because it is hundredths place. So we have to multiply with the 1 upon 100. Second says 2.03. So here 2 is in the unit place. So 2 multiplied by 1 plus 0 multiplied by 1 upon 10 plus 3 multiplied by 1 upon 100. Then the third one. Third one says 200.03. 200.03. So here 2 is in which form? Which place? Units place? Tens place? Hundreds place. So 2 is in hundreds place. So we have to multiply 2 by 100. Then 0 by 10. Then again 0 by 1. Then again 0 by 1 upon 10 because right side. And then 3 is in the hundredths. So 3 multiplied by 1 upon 100. That is the expanded form. And the last, the fourth one. Fourth one says 2.034. So here 2 is in the ones place, means 2 multiplied by 1. Then on the right side, first is the tenths place. So 0 multiplied by 1 upon 10. Next is 3. 3 multiplied by 1 upon 100. In the last is the thousandths place. So plus 4 multiplied by 1 upon 1000. So that is the expanded form. Expanded form means what? We have to separate the digits along with their place value. So now here we are going to end this video, and if you have any problem, write down in the comment section. But after that you will get a PDF file. Whatever is there you must write down. Maybe there is some homework also, and then you can write down in your notebook. Thank you very much.